Hi there, Doug Stimmel with IT Creations with the 2U Supermicro Hyper A Plus server, 2125HS-TNR. As an A Plus server, this system has AMD EPYC processors. In this case, fourth generation AMD EPYC 9004 series processors for some seriously crazy core counts at up to 96 cores each. With that many cores available, this platform is a great option for virtualized workloads, but it's also designed for software-defined storage, AI inference and machine learning, cloud computing, and general use as an enterprise server. With both of those processors installed, this system can support up to 6 terabytes of DDR5 memory modules. Storage options are also flexible in that front panel with support for SAS, SATA, or NVMe drive types. Although I will mention front drive support will affect your PCI options. I mean, even with up to 160 PCI 5.0 lanes, there are still some limitations. In addition, you also get what AMD is calling bonus lanes. Yes, 12 PCI 3.0 bonus lanes. They don't really play up those extra lanes, but au contraire, mon ami, these are useful, kind of like that little toy you get in one of those Kinder chocolate eggs. The 9004 series CPUs offer a chiplet design just like AMD's other EPYC CPUs. The 9004 series CPUs have strung 12 Zen 4 8-core dies together for up to 96 cores in total. These do continue AMD's travel through Italy, this time stopping in Genoa. AMD's next generation Infinity Fabric connects those next generation Zen 4 cores together for twice the speed of the previous generation. In comparison, Intel uses their Quick Path Interconnect, or QPI. I don't know about you, but aside from the definite performance strides of AMD's EPYC 9004 series CPUs, I do think AMD is killing it on the naming side of things too. Infinity Fabric? It sounds like the next Marvel movie for Ant-Man or Doctor Strange or something. These processors also provide the highest memory bandwidth, with 12 memory channels per CPU. The I/O performance I found to be a little misleading because AMD is comparing to Intel Ice Lake CPUs, which is the third generation Intel scalable processor. Sapphire Rapids is the newest fourth generation CPU. The Supermicro Hyper A Plus Server 2125HS-TNR is available at IT Creations right now. For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system listed on our site or one that you can configure that's priced at $5,000 or more. How? Just mention this video when you're ready to make a purchase. ITcreations.com. Intel has an acceleration feature for their fourth generation processor, which is something AMD has not integrated into their silicon. For certain applications, this gives Intel a tri-fold improvement in performance per watt over just the previous Ice Lake or third generation series processors. I will also point out that third gen Intel Xeon scalable processors support 40 cores max, DDR4 memory and PCI 4.0. For AI and machine learning, the 4th gen Sapphire Rapids CPUs are boasting 10 times their performance. Also new is support for up to 60 cores each, PCI 5.0 and DDR5 memory, so there are reasons AMD chose to compare their 4th gen processors to the 3rd gen Intel Xeons instead of Sapphire Rapids. What is it with this fascination with Italy? Even Intel is going on a European vacation. Their Center GPU Max Series Ponte Vecchio, that lovely architectural landmark, is located where? Florence, Italy. Remember when we did a chart mapping AMD's CPU path through Italy, starting with Naples, then Rome, Milan, and now Genoa? Thought it was kind of strange they skipped over Florence. I think we know why now. I also think we're getting a little off track here. On the left server ear, there's a control panel. It includes the power on button, a unit ID button, plus a few status LEDs below those for power, HDDs, NIC1, NIC2, a power fail LED, and a universal information LED. The other server ear features Supermicro branding. 24 storage bays in between. On the back of the system, there is dual power supply units on the lower left. Redundancy is based on how the system is configured, with several options including 1200 watts, 1600 watts, 2000 watts, and 2600 watt options. 1600 watts is standard equipment. Beside that, an RJ45 port to access the ASSPEED AST2600 baseboard management controller, and two USB ports. Next, a VGA port and a slot for an advanced I/O module or AIOM card, as Supermicro likes to call them, but can also be used to support an OCP 3.0 Mezzanine card. As there are no integrated NICs on the back of the system, all network communications are handled via the AIOM or network card inserted in one of those PCI slots, several PCI slots above. This is where it gets interesting. CPU 1 is in charge of those slots on the right, and CPU 2 gets all of the other slots located above the PSUs and the OCP 3.0 Mezzanine card slot. Honestly, the whole numbering convention for those slots works, but the options are a little confusing and, like I said earlier, have a lot to do with how the storage is configured. There are three risers that can be used for the expansion cards. For SATA and SAS drives, you can have four PCIe 5.0 by 16 slots. That would be slots 1, 3, 5, and 7, or 8 PCIe 5.0 by 8 slots with slots 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, basically all of them. If you install a full set of NVMe drives up front, only slots 3 and 4 will be available for a by 16 slot and a by 8 slot. The good thing is there are NVMe ports littering the system board to connect all of those NVMe drives from the backplane. I placed a list of most of the alternate PCIe configurations so you can pause if need be. There were a few more in the user's manual, but let's just leave it at that. Like I said, that by 16 Mezzanine card slot on the system board takes one of Supermicro's AIOM units or an OCP 3.0 card. If you hate acronyms, that would be an Open Compute Project 3.0 card. The benefit is adding more network interface controller ports or NIC ports without taking up those PCIe slots. Clearly there is an argument for that given PCIe availability depending on the configuration. That MLAN port or management LAN port on the back of the system can be used for remote management of the system. It supports the Intelligent Platform Management Interface 2.0 protocol for virtual media over LAN and KVM over LAN support. Supermicro does provide some software options for managing this system, like SuperDoctor 5.0 and Watchdog. A few more include Supermicro Server Manager, Supermicro Update Manager, and Supermicro Power Manager. The Supermicro Server Manager is more for data center deployments. It offers a one-to-many web-based console used to monitor, manage, and get alerts. Supermicro offers various software bundles or licensing levels, like Standard, which requires no license, and then there's Basic, Advanced, and Enterprise, that last of which offers third-party vendor support. All of these bundles include SuperDoctor 5.0, which is a one-to-one application targeting a single appliance, but still includes monitoring, control, and management functions. With both processors installed, the system will support up to 6 terabytes of memory using all 24 memory module slots and outfitted with 256 gigabyte registered memory modules in all slots. That would be DDR5 memory modules. DDR5 offers a performance upgrade compared to DDR4 memory of up to 1.6 times the throughput with memory speeds of up to 4,800 megatransfers per second. DDR5 will also be a bit more than DDR4 memory modules of the same capacity, but only DDR5 is supported. With 12 memory channel architecture, it's recommended that all slots are populated for best performance. I will say that the CPUs are capable of supporting up to 6 terabytes each, and that might be why there is a note in the datasheet for the system stating a maximum of 512 gigabyte ECC 3DS RDIMMs. That said, right above, it indicates a cap of 6 terabytes total, which is repeated in the user manual. This is probably where some of those bonus PCIe 3.0 slots come into play because there are two PCIe 3.0 by 4 slots on the system board. Those can be used to support the operating system with dual NVMe M.2 drives in mirror mode. Those are for boot only. There is no mention of GPUs in the datasheet, user manual, or the landing page. With support for AI inference and machine learning, this system is crying out for that option, which is probably something they just haven't completed testing on. The full width, full length slots are there. Not to mention perhaps one of those Grade Supreme RAID SR-1010 cards for support of NVMe RAID options with PCIe 5.0 compatibility. But this is all getting a bit ahead of what is actually listed in the materials. Dual 4th generation AMD EPYC 9004 series processors, 24 hybrid storage bays up front, several PCIe Gen 5 expansion slots, depending on that storage configuration, and up to 6 terabytes of DDR5 memory. The Supermicro Hyper A Plus server 2125HS-TNR is a flexible platform that can be configured to support a number of different workloads. If you're looking, try itcreations.com. We have this server in stock and can configure it to your specifications. If you've made it this far, hit that subscribe button. If you have any questions, post them in the comments section below. I also placed a few links in the description if you want more information on this system. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.